years of the buffalo type. By the 1880s, great buffalo herds, better friends, and domestic animals. Ss Moyie, which sailed at Cooney Lake in southeastern BC for almost 60 years, from 1898 to 1957. This vessel, superficially similar, represented the Gothic Star Wars. It operated on the lakes and rivers of Western Canada in the late 1800s and early 1900s. Nearly all the original steamships were owned by railway companies, which used them to supplement their rail transport systems. In the era before widespread rail transportation, they provided a vital link for both passengers and freight between waterside towns and the nearest rail connection points. The original Moyie still exists, although she is no longer afloat. She has been beautifully restored and is now a National Historic Site, located in the town of Castle, B.C. The name Moyie is derived from the French word Moule, which translates in English to wet conditions. To our port side is the grain elevator. The grain elevator was built by the Security Elevator Company of Winnipeg, which is 250 miles northeast of Calgary. Grain elevators are an important part of early prairie grain cutting. The elevators take advantage of the fluid properties of grain, thus reducing the need for manual labor to store and move it. They were a much more efficient way of loading grain onto rail cars for shipping.
Thank you. now they're going to put down the plank and let us off. Thank you. Are they going to be doing a man overboard drill soon? Thank you very much.
Thank you.
What is the man overboard drill?
Oh, we've already done that one. It was it did not go super well.
When was it?
When was it?
Yeah.
It was like a
week or
two ago.
Nice. Do you usually do one with the passengers on board?
We did this year. Yes. We also just did an emergency
drill.
Honey.
Nice. I've got to head up.
Thank you for
You're welcome.